So I'm going to introduce Ronan Collins. He's the Managing Director of InteliBuild, successful entrepreneur and a strong advocate for BIM and new technologies applied in the construction space. Please give him a warm round of applause.
Good morning, everybody. So this is an example from an architectural practice. Building information modeling, or basically 3D modeling for architects and engineers. This is a 3D computer model of a school project. And the architect has worked out their design, they've worked out the locations of the classrooms and anything else. They want to present to their customer or their client. So they take a 3D printer similar to the MakerBot that we have here. You can see it being 3D printed. And they print the building in layers. So floors, walls, components of the building. And then you can see this is a time lapse where they actually put all the components together. And you can see there's quite a lot of intricate details. You can actually see the different classrooms, you can see the different corridors. You can get right down to, they've printed the cars and the car park, which is a bit of a touch of perfection, which is what we expect from the architects. And then you can see how the whole building is assembled. But a bit like when we were kids, like with Lego, you can take the bits apart. So you can actually lift off floor by floor, and you can see how the different room layers are done. So what we're finding is that in our industry, you can have a 3D model, but people won't necessarily look at it, they won't necessarily walk around through it. But if you actually generate a 3D model like this, people can put it on the boardroom table, they can play with it, and then you start getting some very interesting feedback from the actual ultimate users, which are the teachers. This morning, I've got a couple of examples from one of our clients. We work a lot with Gammon Construction. On the table there, they've lent me one of their 3D models. They actually have a 3D printer in-house, so they've actually invested in the 3D printer itself. This is a project we've just completed. It's the new midfield concourse at Hong Kong Airport. It's got a very complicated roof steelwork system on top. So you can see here from this video, from the construction site, the actual curvature of the steelwork. At the beginning of the project, to get our heads around the actual geometry of the roof, how the roof is connected to the concrete structure, we actually printed a part of the building. So we took the engineer's 3D model of the actual steelwork, we put it in a 3D printer, and I'll show you the 3D printed model. So this is an actual part of the 3D printed model. It's very, very useful talking to the steel fabricator, talking to the curtain walling contractors, talking to the guys on site, to get them to start to understand the complexities of how we build these very, very tall structures and how we interconnect all the trusses and everything else. So it's very, very powerful communication technology. We took it one step further. We actually started 3D printing pipe racks. So we started doing printed assemblies for major piping systems. And one of the things we're looking at was maintenance. Could we actually get enough space between the systems to get access to valves, get access to hangers and all the like? So again, the engineers, like, you can see them here, they're measuring with actually a scale measuring tape. You can actually, because the thing is so accurate, you can actually take dimensions off it and check things. So it's very, very powerful when you're prototyping things. This is one of my favorite ones I've seen in the last couple of weeks. This is actually in Chungpano. It's a very, very large site, and they're having to excavate two levels of a basement. And again, you can see here the site engineers, they've got a 3D printed model of the entire site. So they've actually printed the retaining walls, the structural platforms, and they're using it to plan how they're going to excavate this huge hole in the ground. So you have this model on the site, you can see all the different layers of steelwork, you can see all the different layers of excavation, and the boys are just pointing at it, this is what it looks like, this is what it looks like. The advantage of this, to be able to produce the 3D model, the actual physical 3D model, you have to do the actual 3D CAD model, which means you have to solve all the engineering problems. So by getting to the physical model, you've actually figured out a lot of the construction difficulties. So there's a process by which the contractors go through, using the BIM process to actually, in CAD, figure out where the steel goes, and then actually getting it all the way through to construction. This is the new Chun Mun Chap Lok link. I probably missed that one word in there. Gammon are building the highway which connects the existing airport highway into the new border crossing for the Macau Zhuhai Bridge. This is all built out over the water. So the 3D printed model I've got with this morning is one of these segments for the bridge. So what they do is they precast the concrete segment in China, they barge it in, and they use these massive crane gantries, and they stitch all these things together. So the 3D model here, it's designed to see how the shear keys work. It looks at where the tendons are in, the steel tendons go through the things to look at them. And it also starts to look at how you actually put the balustrades on, how you put the piping in for drainage, how you put the cables in. So the 3D printing model for this project was used to test some of the design. This is the kind of printing that you've been hearing about all morning. What's of interest to me is actually how to actually physically build assets using these technologies. How do we actually 3D print a building? There are two materials that are most common, steel and concrete. In the steel industry, we use a technology called laser sintering. So laser sintering, you basically inject an iron or metal powder into a nozzle, and then you heat it up. And then you have a 5-axis turntable. The turntable is spinning, and you'll see in a second they can actually tilt it. This is actually for an aeronautical application, so it's a casing for an aeronautical component. And you tilt the machine to a certain angle, and it will then start to change the shape of the profile of the pipe. So you can see that we can actually do proper additive, they call it additive manufacturing. So you can create very large, very complicated metal components, and you can see in 6 minutes they've created this particular component. In the metal industry, this is where this is heading for, is this laser sintering. So we can actually create real world objects which can be used in planes, cars, and eventually in buildings. But when it comes to buildings, the current research, this is taken from a research project in Loughborough University in the UK, they've created full-scale gantries. They can actually print concrete. So you actually pump concrete into the nozzle. So instead of pumping plastic in, you pump concrete in. So they've done a prototype using a 3D printer. This is the old school 3D printing where they actually use powder. So here we have traditional concrete, so it's a cementitious blend. This is the actual rig, and this is the printing nozzle. So it's a very, very large gantry. And what they're doing here is they're just doing printed components. So they're trying to print a facade component. You'll see that the concrete comes out as basically paste, and you can see the layers building up. It doesn't look particularly fancy, but it has huge potential because they can actually 3D print, they can put in the piping for electrical systems, they can put in piping for drainage systems. We can reinforce this with steel or with fiber. So we can actually make these things very, very substantial structurally, and then you can start to stack them up. The architects will not like it because of the aesthetic ribs that it creates. But this is an indication of where the technology is going. We will get to a point where we can actually 3D print the building, turn the lights on, and sit down and have a cup of tea and relax. So, but I think that's probably 20 years away. So that's my part on construction 3D printing. Back to you. Thank you, Ronan.